Hello and welcome to the G-Code 2D Plotter Art Library Quick Start. First thing we want to do is we actually want to switch over to the Universal G-Code Center. We want to find the dimensions of the piece of paper that we're going to be plotting on. And basically we'll do this by setting an x equals 0, y equals 0 on a graph, and then we'll find the width and the height of our piece of paper, and then we'll enter that into our plotting library. So to do that, we'll come over here to the jog controller, and before we jump in, you want to set these values here. We'll set the step size to be 10. We can ignore the Z size unless you have a 3D printer. We'll set this to 10 and then this to 10,000 for now. And the reason specifically we want to set the step size XY to be 10 is that this is 10 millimeters. So every time we press one of these buttons, the plotter will move 10 millimeters. And you want to keep these values small because you might accidentally run your plotter into the wall and grind your motors if you make a movement that goes beyond the range of your plotter. So keep these values small and we will get our X and Y. So move these pens out of the way. And we're gonna wanna go to the bottom left corner. All right, so that looks like a good starting point. And so now we wanna tell the plotter that this is zero, X equals zero, Y equals zero. So we'll hit reset zero. And now we'll see that X is zero, Y is zero. And if we go ahead and move up a little bit, we'll see that these have both changed by 10. And then we can come back here and hit return to zero, and we'll go back to zero, zero. So now we want to get the maximum, or the width, and the height of our piece of paper. And so we can do that by coming back to the jog controller, and now we know roughly how we're moving about. We can set these numbers higher until we get to where we want to go. Okay, so that looks good for Y. That was close for X, so we'll drop this back down to 10. So we get it right up against the edge. And we'll see that our numbers are width of 230, height of 160. So we'll come back here, make a quick comment, and we'll write those down. The next thing we want to adjust is the feed rate. And so if the movement around was good for you, you can leave that as is, or you can try and make it higher or lower. And we can see, like, if we make it lower or even lower, goes a little bit slower. And I found through experimentation that 10,000 is a good number. Okay, so now we can start importing the library that we're using. We are gonna import Plotter2D because we're using a 2D plotter right now. And we'll go ahead and set up the Plotter class. And we've given it a title of Plotter2D Quick Start. And the title in combination with the output directory we'll define where these files get saved on our computer. Next up, we have the values xmin, xmax, ymin, ymax, which came from our measurements before. And so we'll plug those in, and then feed rate set to 10,000, which came from before. We have these two include params. So include border layer will actually draw a layer around your piece of art. And so we're not gonna do that for now. And then include preview layer will do an outline without touching the paper to show you how big your piece of art will be. And this is useful to make sure that everything ends up on the paper. It's a good sanity check before we start plotting. And lastly, we have handle out of bounds, which will throw a warning in down below if the thing that you are plotting is outside of the bounds of your plotter. You can check this to error so that your whole thing will fail, or silent so it says nothing, but we'll set it to warning just so we can see. Okay, so now with our plotter set up, we wanna go ahead and define our things that we're going to use to draw with. So I have a blue marker, a green marker, and a black pen. So I've defined them here with variables. And we want to go ahead and add each of those to our plotter. So for each of those layers, we can add it. The next two fields, color and line width, are used when previewing the piece of art before you actually plot it. And so this is just for you, the user, to check that your work actually makes sense. And we'll look at the preview in a second. But basically, you can define a color, either hex or human readable. And so I've chosen black, blue, and then an example hex value, which represents green for these layers. And then line width is roughly how thick you want the lines to be. And I found that a pen is around 1 and a thick marker is around 4. So that's what I've set here. You might want to change these values when you're plotting, but this is a good starting point. All right, so now with our layers defined, we can go ahead and actually start adding some different instructions. So we will see here that first up to our black pen layer, we're gonna add a rectangle with some dimensions. You'll notice that if these dimensions, These dimensions should fit within your params that you define when setting up your plotter. And so if, for example, the Y end is outside of the bounds of your plotter and you try and run this code, you'll get a warning that you failed to add a point because it was outside of the bounds. So make sure everything falls within the bounds of your plotter as you're adding them. All right, so we're gonna add a rectangle, we're gonna add a point, a circle, another rectangle, another path, and a line. And each of these are added to different layers. And you can plot basically, right now supported are points, circles, rectangles, and paths. And a path is just a collection of points, each signified by an X and a Y. All right, so now all of our points and shapes and things are ready to go. We can go ahead and generate a preview. And as I mentioned earlier, the color and the line width will help you decide, or will generate in the preview. So we can see here that our piece of art will be roughly 100 in the Y direction and then 80 in the X direction. And see, in total, we added a black rectangle, which we can see here, a point, a circle, another rectangle, and a path, and a line throughout our piece here. And so with the preview looking good, we can go ahead and close that out. And then we'll add one last line, which is the save, which will save our piece of work or to plot in the output directory / plotter2d quick start. So we'll run everything. Once you preview it, close it, it'll save. And now we can switch back over to our Universal G-Code Center. We can go ahead and open up and we'll see that there are our layers. They are numbered in the order in which they were added to the plotter. We'll start with the preview, just to get a rough outline of things. So here's the code here. You can read more with a bunch of comments and there are descriptions in the documentation of what each of these instructions mean. But for now, we'll just use this and just use it as our preview. Okay, so we have our preview layer loaded and we can go ahead and now preview the bounds of our print. As we switch back over to the piece of paper, you'll notice that I had some technical difficulty, so actually some of the shapes have already been drawn. We'll ignore that for now, because I don't want to change out the paper. So we go ahead and run the preview layer, and we'll get a nice little outline, and then a little X pattern, which will just show what the middle looks like. Sometimes when your paper's warped, you might notice that you accidentally draw in the middle, so this is useful to prevent that. All right, so now with that good, we're gonna go ahead, and since we already have the blue marker attached, we will open that one up. I'll go ahead and remove the pen cap. And as you can probably guess, as we run this, it will just draw over the lines that are already there. Perfect. Okay, so when you are changing whatever you're using to plot with, it's always useful to kind of find a little marker as a reference point. So here I can see that this little T right here I will use on the other marker as well. So I'll use it as a reference point, and when I slide this back on, I will match it up there. And this is useful to make sure that everything is close to where you're expected to be when you're plotting. So we will line it up there with the T. Slide this back on. Okay, now we can open up the green layer and then we'll repeat the process. Okay, and then lastly, we can switch over to the black pen. All right, and so since the pen and the marker are slightly different, we'll want to just kind of hold this so the tips are at the same height. And we'll see that I roughly want this little black piece here to line up with in there. So I'll just try and line things up as I add it in. And that seems like a good height for our pen. All right, and now we can go ahead and run our last layer. Let's move this. this out of the way. You'll see that there is our plotted example. And so that is the quick start. I recommend reading into the documentation to learn more. There's a bunch of helpful tips, tricks, and more in-depth details of what you can do with this library.